What up, y'all? This is Jeremiah McPherson. Hallelujah. Johnson coming right back at you. This is the intro for Mortal Kombat Training Day 324. Let's get straight into it. We got 1,825 days of simple disciplines, 1,825 days of studying, 1,825 days of building myself, teaching myself how to think, 1,825 days of my disciplines giving me confidence, 1,825 days of keeping the mind sharp because it is a weapon, 1,825 days of bringing more value to the job than they're paying me for, 1,825 days of looking forward to my planned future, not negative things in my past, 1,825 days of boxing, 1,825 days of working out, 1,825 days of tracking my calories, 1,825 days of doing porn, 1,825 days of going to work, 1,825 days of consistently working, 1,825 days of Mongol mentality, 1,825 days of sticking to my values, 1,825 days of working on my strategy, 1,825 days of keeping it pimping, 1,825 days of staying so icy on these bitches, 1,825 days of making extra money off the porn I make, 1,825 days of reading, listening to audiobooks, 1,825 days of journaling, 1,825 days of recording content. We got a few things that I'm grateful for. I'm grateful to have fun every day on my porn journey. I'm grateful to be on my porn journey. I'm grateful for porn, Plan 5150. You can't control every situation, but you can control how you act and you think about the situation. With that being said, fuck April Jones, fuck Bambi, fuck Stephanie Santiago, fuck LeBron, fuck Drea, fuck Puffy, fuck Dr. Dre, fuck Jay-Z, fuck Beyonce, fuck Kanye West, fuck Tiger, fuck Sauce Walker, fuck Kim Kardashian, fuck the game, fuck Wes Watson, fuck Eric Thompson, fuck Floyd Mayweather, fuck 50 Cent, fuck CT Fletcher, fuck The Hawk, fuck Rihanna, fuck Anthony Gallo, fuck Paul Xavier, fuck the white boy neighbor with the two bitches, fuck Kelly Muscle, fuck Jocko, fuck 21 Savage, fuck Meek Mills, fuck Lauren London. So let's read a few quotes and then put this video together and then post it. Yeah, feeling good, happy to be here recording my disciplines again. This is a quote from Brian Tracy. Most people engage in activities that are tension relieving rather than goal achieving. Let's see. Some more quotes. Good quotes. These help me a lot. This is from Marcus Aurelius. A man must stand erect, not be kept erect by others. And this is from Bruce Lee. Keep blasting because life is such. Sometimes it's nice and sometimes it's not. Some more quotes. This is from Da Vinci. Learning is the only thing the mind never exhausts, never fears, and never regrets. Let's see if I got one more here. This is from Mel Robbins. No one is coming. If you are waiting for someone to come rescue you, discover you, motivate you, pick you, or push you out of your comfort zone, you have already lost. So this is Mortal Kombat Training Day 324. This is Jeremiah McPherson, Hallelujah Johnson, and I'm right back at y'all.
Ourselves a four-round combo build-up shadow boxing workout. Now we're going to work on the fundamentals, the foundational movements when it comes to boxing. And like any good fighter, we are going to end with abs. However, today we're going to get started and use those six punches and use that body from head to toe. Let's smile. Let's get our body warmed up and let's be present right now. Let's get this warm up going with some arm circles here in three, in two, and three. Getting arm circles going forward, smooth, small, light circles, and now take them backwards. Good breathing in, gathering your mind, get those thoughts present, and let's transition to heel down, toe up. Go ahead and bend that back knee, reach down, point the hand towards the opposite foot. Stretching out those hamstrings and those hips, getting that mind prepared to crush it today. Let's go to a torso twist now, nice and easy. Rotate from the ball of the foot all the way up to the top of the head. Kind of getting that rotational aspect here warmed up and built in. Every punch that you throw should require rotational force. You should be turning from the toe all the way up to the head. It's going to be opposite hand, opposite foot. But spread the legs, drive those hips straight back. We are almost halfway done. our light dynamic warm-up. Let's go to a squat now, get nice and low. Drive those hips up, and then we're gonna turn into a three. Same thing on the other side. You squat down, come all the way up, rotate and turn the four. 15 more seconds here. I know you're ready to use that whole body, and I know that this light warm-up is gonna get you a little prepared for greatness. For our final 30 seconds in our warm-up today, we got boxer's bounce in a boxer stance. I just want you to move front to back. Nice and easy, moving both of the feet, landing, controlled, keeping the hands up, getting a little comfortable, right? Having a little fun. That's it. All right, pick up that pace. We get a whole minute of rest and recovery coming up here, all right? Now, if you don't feel like your heart rate's up, you can keep your boxer's bounce going. For the rest of us, we're gonna take a deep breath in, exhale out, and get our mind focused. Now we're gonna keep this first round super basic, mostly working two punch combination. Don't have to have an extrinsic, super long combo to make it great. Sometimes we just need to work on the foundation of punch. So we're gonna work 30 seconds of one and two, jab, cross. Then we got 30 seconds of cross, lead hook, two, three. From there, we go three, four. From there, four, five. From there, five, six. And then we finish the last 30 seconds with a three punch combo. We're gonna throw six, one, two. Our uppercut, jab, cross. Shadow boxing is foundational and key. So let's hone in our skills. Let's get into our stance. Let's throw that one, two. Jab and cross. Good extension on the jab. Shift that weight, throw the two. Now if you can, sync up your punch with your breath. So on my exhale, extend and throw that punch. Bring it right back. Imagine your lungs being this giant balloon. I want to slowly seep air out as I punch. That's it. Come on, three, two. Let's go to the second combo now. Two, three. Good rear cross. Follow it with that lead hook. Chamber those punches. So as one hand extends out, the other one is already in rotation. All right? Don't waste movement. Don't waste any energy. Let's perfect this shadow boxing craft. Five more seconds. Then we're gonna throw both hooks. Okay, this should be the easiest of the six combos. Let's go three, then the four. Turn the hip, turn over top, and bring that hand with the core, not just the arm. All right. 15 more seconds. Keep those punches going. If you got a little bit more speed right now, throw it. Don't be afraid to go a little harder and to go a little farther than you thought you could. Here we go. Let's go to the fourth combination. We're going to go four, five. Rear hook, lead uppercut. Shift the weight, then drive the hip up towards your opponent. Woo. Now, shadow boxing has been utilized, practiced, and perfected by every prospect, every contender, and every great champion. And I expect you to do the same. Build the skills. Here we go. Let's go to five and six. Now lead uppercut and the rear uppercut. Two uppercuts, driving the hips up and down, not just the arm. You want to make sure that the whole hip is being utilized. We're almost done. 7 seconds, we go to our three punch combination. Six, one, two. Ready, set, let's throw it. Six, one, and two. Rear uppercut, good jab. Follow it with the cross. Stay balanced, bring the hands right back at home. Protecting yourself at all times. Come on. Good extension. Hands right back at home. You got this. We got this. We're going to get an entire minute of rest in three, Yes, two. And one. Shake it out. Stay loose. Good breathing. Get that mind ready to crush the rest of these incredible rounds. In round two, we're going to build up a combo. We're going to go from a boxer's bounce to a one, to a one, two, to a one, two, three, to a one, two, three, four, to a one, two, three, four, five, and then finally, one, two, three, four, five, and six. All six punches in a long combination. Now here's the cool part. We're perfecting and practicing the craft of shadow boxing. It's a part of boxing. It's something that you should incorporate, but like all real and amazing fighters, after we get done our shadow boxing, we get those gloves on and we go to the bag. And that's where that full experience comes in with fight camp. Having gloves, having a bag, and having trackers that help you get to your goal 3 times faster. Let's go to boxer's bounce. Nice and easy, all right? Like our warm-up, move the feet, and every now and then, when you feel like it, pop the jab out, hands right back. Think about Ali in his prime, snapping a jab, and then making his opponent miss. You can get a little fancy with the hands if you want. Pop that jab out every now and then. This is the only chance in the round where you're gonna move really, you know? Get ready. 3 seconds, you plant those feet down, and we go one, two. Period. One, then the two. Good jab. Follow it with a cross. Hands come right back behind. Think about where you're landing this punch at. All right, try to use those top two knuckles wherever you're placing that punch at. Good jab. Good jab is going to always set up the other punches. So, throw it well, throw it sharp. Let's add three. One, two, and then the three. Good jab. Better cross. Finish it with that lead hook. As you shift your weight from that lead leg to that rear leg. There you go. Now as you're rotating and turning those hips, I want you to remember that every punch should involve the entire body. Using the whole core, use that trunk. Let's add the four. One, two, three, then the four. Good jab, good cross, better lead hook. And you finish with that rear hook to knock them out. Good. Now this combo buildup, this is one of the many aspects and training formats that we have in the full fight camp experience. Now we're gonna add that five in 3, 2, 1. Let's add the five. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Don't forget about good breathing. That's it, come on. We're almost all the way through. Round number two. Breathe. Believe in yourself here, especially if this might feel awkward. All right, let's add the six. There it is, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. All 6 punches, quick, efficient. I'm already sweating here a little bit. That's it, come on, 10 more seconds. Work through the round, build the skills, cause they pay the bills. We're done round number 2 and 3, 2 and 1. Shake it out. If you wanna keep that body moving, that's okay. The rest of us, we're gonna chill. Breathe, shake it out. Now as we simulate a real fighting round. 3 on, 1 off. I want you to keep that mind here, all right? Every step, every punch is gonna take you closer towards that goal that you set. And your goal is different than mine. So come back to your why every now and then, especially as the team sets in. This round, we're gonna work that lead hook and that rear hook in a variety of ways. We start off with a 3-4. Then we go 3-4-5-B. Then we go 3-4-5-B-1. And then finally, we got 1 minute, 3-4-5-B, which is nothing but the body. 1-2, all right? And then our last 30 seconds, just like our warm-up, squat 3, squat 4, Let's get round number three out the way. Threes and fours now. Lead hook, then the rear hook. Good lead. Follow it with the rear. Shift that weight and bring the hands right back. Remember where I said you're pointing your knuckle at. I want you to keep your head at your target. I never want to throw a punch and then turn my head the other way. Eyes always at the target. That old phrase, eyes on the prize. Here we go. Let's add a five to the body. Lead uppercut down low. Think about where your body area is. And land in the same space. Three, four, five, big. There's always going to be a level change in boxing, okay? So punches up top, bring the hands up. But then that means that the body's wide open. Vice versa, when you throw those body shots, you're going to open up the guard and bring it back down. And land the punches back to top. Let's add the one. Three, four, five, B. One. Level change. Two punches up top, one to the body, and then one back up top to the face. Very good. Elbows tight. Learn how to control that body. If we're doing this well, imagine when we put the gloves on, start adding strength conditioning, dynamic warm-ups, start ending with abs. Let's add the two now. Three, four, five feet, one, and two. Three, four, five feet, one, two. Hands right back at home. Don't forget to move the feet a little bit as you feel comfortable. Stay balanced. Not too much weight on that lead foot. Not too much weight on the rear foot. Stay with this combo for another 30 seconds. Three, four, five feet, one, two. Come on, keep pushing. And yes, it's occurred to me that throwing punches in the air, beating the shadow, it feels weird. It feels awkward. Sometimes it might even keep you from actually starting. Don't allow that mental block to keep you from being great. Let's work those legs. Ready? Squat down. Get nice and low. Come up top. Give me a good three. And then switch. Squat down. Ha! Give me a nice four. Gotta build those legs up. Ha! That's where power comes from. Mike Tyson was known for his killer power. And where'd it come from? The legs. Come on. We're done round number three in five, four, three, two, and one. Hey, that's it. We're almost there. And I'm sweating my face off already. But you know what? If it don't challenge you, it ain't gonna change you. And that's what we're all about here at Fight Camp. Pushing you to the best version of you every single day. From our end with abs to our dynamic warm-ups to the 4, 8, 6, and 10 round hard-working boxing and kickboxing routines. We make sure that you get better. And we have data to back it up. So you're gonna make progress. Trust me. All right, last one, best one, round number four. We start on the floor with a little bit of core. We're gonna do a full sit-up, and we're gonna throw a one and a two. Then we apply this onto our feet for a four-punch combo. One, two, three, two. Then we add or take away a punch. One, two, three, one, two. And the last minute's the best minute. Push-up, one, two. Power comes on, two. Start down on the floor. Here we go. Round number four. Give me a good sit-up. Give me a jab. Give me a cross. Let's get a pretty good pace here, all right? Shadow boxing workouts can be challenging, but it's mostly through your pace and your effort here, all right? Try to get more sit-ups than you ever have in a 30-second burst. Push, push, push. We rise to our feet. Three, two, one. Right to a four-punch combo. One, two, three, two. Jab. Rear cross, lead hook, rear cross again. Hands right back at home. Turn the knuckle. Drive from the core. Keep going. These punches aren't going to necessarily get more difficult. We're going to take a punch off in three, In two, one. Let's go one, two, three now. Jab, cross, lead hook. Here it is, the finish line. That's it, come on. Work. Turn the body. Keep the mind focused on achieving greatness. Even with this time right now. We're gonna take another punch off and just throw the one and the two. Ready, set, let's go. One and two. Jab, cross, hands right back at home. Ha, ha. Don't forget about moving your feet as you receive fit. That's it. Breathe. We're coming up on that final minute here. All right, we're gonna work some upper body. Push up one, push up two, and we power coach. Ready, drop down on the ground, let's get it. Good push up, chest touches the floor, rise all the way up, and extend that punch all the way out. Another good push up, rotate, throw that punch. This is where the finish line gets close. That's not a reason to stop, that's a reason to go further. 10 seconds, you're gonna throw power, even without a bag or gloves on. We're gonna throw that one, two with all the effort you got. Ready, let's go. On your feet, power, power. Shift that weight, ha. Throw these punches here with a little bit more intention. Ha. Drive your hips, ha. Ha. Imagine punching through a wall. Ha. Don't hit the wall, don't hit the wall yet. Ha. Come on, ha. Ha. Full extensions, good power. Ha. We're almost done. Come on, finish strong. Three, two, and one.
Goodness, some power. And the way that I've divided up each of these rounds is we're gonna do four exercises, two times through, and then we're gonna finish with 60 seconds of some core work to make sure we're hitting the full body experience. So we're gonna start off with some torso twist, arm swings, just to kind of get loosened up. In three, two, one. Let your arms go, turn your heels out here. Let it go, just let it go. We're gonna move and groove through this today. I'm gonna be challenging you full body. 30 seconds of each exercise, and then we're gonna finish with that hard work, 1 minute to go into the rest. You up in between before you step back again. Then we're gonna do reverse lunge and do the right leg. Moving into some bear squats, which are gonna be down on the ground, and then we're gonna repeat this and finish off with that 60 seconds of core work to really burn it out for the end of the round. So squat, knee to elbow. Let's get it. Feet hip width apart. Sit down in your chair, drive through your heels and your big toe. Try to really touch your knee to your elbow as you rotate at the top. Squeeze your core here. Really trying to pull it in. Pull it into the back of your spine. Beautiful work. We're going to start with our left leg first on these reverse lunges. And let's go. Step back. Down the elevator. Up. Kick forward. Down. And we're going to keep going with that. Now, as you throw that kick, extend forward, just like you would if you're kicking the back. Try to keep your hands up. Beautiful. Couple more seconds and then we're gonna go right side. Two, and switch, other side. Step back, down the elevator. See how my knee's behind my toes? Up, kick. Beautiful, make sure you're breathing. As we move through these exercises quite swiftly. We got five rounds, taking one round at a time, giving everything we got one round at a time. Drop down for bear squat. So from here, I'm up on my toes and my hands. I'm gonna sink my hips back, and then I'm gonna transfer forward to a high plank. Drop down, booty back, and explode to a high plank. Keep going. Now, if you feel like your hips are tight, that's okay. We're opening them up. Working on our legs still. Stand it up. Squat knee to elbow. Let's get it. Round two. Really rotate. Use your torso. Stay with me. Breathe. Two. And left leg. Step back. Kick forward. That modification is stepping back, kicking through, coming back to center. So step back. You can also come to center. Kick, come to center. If you want a challenge, step back, kick, right back into it. Takes a lot more balance and stability to go straight into it. Switch, other leg, right leg. But if you need to return, so you have proper technique and proper balance, I want you to start there. Good work. Almost done here. We're gonna move on to some bear squats and then finish off in our supermans. Drop down, bear squat time. All right, remember, press back into your heels, transfer forward. Up on the balls of your feet. Stay with me. You are almost done with round one. That's it. Two, drop down to your stomach. We got alternating supermans. So hands, legs flat. I'm gonna lift up my right arm and my left leg, and then I'm gonna drop it. Now I'm gonna switch. Left arm, right leg. Now my gaze is slightly forward, not fully up, not fully down. Lift, squeeze your bum, bring it down. I want slow drops to the ground. We're not just plopping like a fish. Bring it up, bring it down, gracefully like an eagle. Like my animal analogies. Stay with me for these final 20 seconds. Finishing strong. And then you get a break. This is the end right here. Working our lower back. That is a part of your core. Three, two, and time. Stand it up. Dust it off. And let's get ready for round two. Go ahead and grab some water if you need some in between. Starting with a squat, punch across the body. So I want you to sit down in your chair. Feet hip width apart, stand up. We're gonna punch across our body. Still rotating. See how this is always consistent. We're not just doing this. You're gonna hurt your knee, keeping it straight. Turn with each punch. Then we're going into a right curtsy lunge with a squat. You're gonna step back behind you, kind of at an angle. Drop it down. See how my leg's straight? It's not bending out. Straight, come back to center, squat. Curtsy, squat. Now we're gonna do the left side after 30 seconds. Drop it down, hit some shoulder taps. Repeat those four exercises and we're gonna finish off with a minute of core for round two. All right, squat, punch across body. Sit down in your chair. Drive up, hands up, turn. Now you can keep your hands by your face so you're ready to go at the top. Still breathing here. I want good technique. Good technique before speed. And if you're feeling fiery, light it up quicker. Now we got right curtsy lunge squat. Right leg steps back at an angle. Drop it down the elevator. Up, center, drop it low. All right, again. Good, now why I like curtsy lunges, or you can call them something a little bit more manly if you want, is that working the side booty. And gentlemen, you need to work it too, okay? Guys have underdeveloped glutes. Other side, let's get it. Step back, down, sit in your chair. Because guys don't go to the gym predominantly to work on their booty. You don't see it very often. But guys, you need to work your glutes just as much, okay? Because you're an athlete. Athletes work their glutes. Good. It is your biggest muscle for a reason. Make sure you're using it to help your sport, not hinder it. Drop it down for some shoulder taps. Walk it out to a high plank. Hold it. Straight as a board back. I'm gonna lift my arm over, touch the opposite shoulder, drop it down. There it is. Try to keep your hips as still as possible. We're not rocking. Keep it still. Hey. Come on. Two and one. Squat punch across body. Let's get it. Full turn. Smush the bug with your toe. Bring it back. Ah, woo! There it is. I'm sweating. It's only round two. Let's go. Right curtsy lunge. Squat. Get it. Woo. Focusing on those muscles we're using. Lots of squats, I know. I know, I'm with you. Let's get it. Step back for that curtsy. Step back. We're not going too far to the side, just at an angle back. Drop down, up, squat at the top. Other side. Left side. Squat. Let's go. You are almost done with this round. Round two. Remember, one round at a time. Good. Focus on your breathing. If anything, when in doubt, focus on your breathing. Slow it down if you have to. And drop it down for some shoulder taps. Walk your feet out. Hold that. Tap it out. Come on. Once we finish this in 15 seconds, we're moving into some side plank thrusters. Okay? Feel free to be on your elbow or your hand in the high plank on your side. Whatever feels better. I know some of you have wrist problems. So whatever feels more comfortable. And we're up. Stacked is a level two. This is level one, level two, level three. Hand on your hip, push it up. Now if you need to modify, bend that bottom leg and be on your knee and then the top leg is straight. Push up from there. It's okay if you have to modify. Two, one, other side. Same thing. Modify by keeping the bottom leg bent or split the legs or stack the feet or raise the top leg, okay? Good. Stay with me. You can also push down on your wrist, your supporting wrist. Drop down to your knee if you need it. Let's go. And time. Woo! Feeling sweaty in the house. Love it. Moving on to round three. Grab some water if you need it. This is what we're doing. We're starting off with some sumo squats. So, hitting all areas of our legs today and our glutes. Angle out, feet outside of your hips. Out. We're gonna drop it down, drive it up. So we're using our adductors and our glutes. If you do it properly, you're not gonna be able to see the floor. You're gonna be looking straight up, postured up, sitting down, driving through, and you should really squeeze your bum at the top. Then we're gonna go right lunge, knee raise. So you're gonna step back or step forward for this lunge and then come to knee raise. Some people prefer the reverse lunge. You can do that and then come to a knee raise. I like the reverse lunge because then I'm not going to hurt my knee. And then we'll bear plank walk and repeat it all. All right, sumo squat, feet outside of our hips. Drop down, just drop like you're trying to pick up a blueberry with your bum. This is a real thing that they do in pelvic floor training, by the way. So drop down, zip it back up, straight to the top. Love it. Ballet dancers, some of the strongest people I know, they do lots of this movement. It's like a plie, except their feet are together. It's crazy. Right reverse lunge, and then we're coming to a knee raise. Hold it. Nice and strong, drive it back down. Now, if you need the modification, come back to center, then step back. Good, hold it there, like a sprinter, hold it. Right back down in your stance. Love it. We're about to switch to the other side. Let's go. Left reverse lunge, drive it up. Now you might find that one of the sides of your body is stronger than the other. It's totally normal. You have a dominant hand or a dominant leg because of the way that you live your life or the way, that was a squat, or the way you train. So for example, my front leg is stronger than my rear leg because this is my stabilizing leg. That's okay, just be aware of this so you know to work it. Drop down, we got a bear plank walk. On your hands, on your knees, lift up onto your toes and we're gonna step with our same side, hand and foot, step. Keep your booty down. Now, back the other way. Good. Love it. Straight from the side. Really pull your stomach in. And pop it back up. We got some sumo squats in the house. Woo! Step out. Drop down. Good. Second time through. Moving and grooving through this workout. You're crushing it. If it doesn't challenge you, it doesn't change you. Why does that have to be such a difficult lesson? Right? Why can't we just have it easy? Right lunge, knee raise. Come on. Very nice. Stay with me. Focusing on your technique. You're halfway done with this round. One more. Knee raise. Switch, other side, left side. Drive. Drive. Ha. Sound effects are not included. You have to do your own, okay? You know, like batteries not included? Okay. I thought it was funny. I won't quit my day job. Come on. We got some bear plank walks next. Drop it low. Let's get it. On your knees and your hands now. Lift up onto your toes. Walk it out. Give yourself a couple paces to the side and then a couple paces the other way. You can also do this forward and back. Booty down. Make sure your hand is good, stepping at the same time. Good work. And on your booty, feet in the air like you just don't care. We got toe touches. Legs straight up to the sky. My shoulders are off the ground. I'm tucking my chin. I'm gonna reach up and touch. I want you to try to keep that tension there. We're not relaxing. I want you to keep your shoulders elevated. Touch. If you have really long legs, you probably have long arms as well. So reach. Not that that's always the case. And if you want to make it more challenging, reach up and touch across. One at a time. If you want that challenge. Come on. Oh! seconds. All the way through the bell. Working that core. Hey. Less than five, three, two, ooh! Time. Pop it up. That was me attempting the moonwalk, but that doesn't work with shoes and a mat, okay? Grabbing on to round four. We're starting with one of my favorites, and y'all are probably gonna hate me after this, but it is such a great full body exercise, and that's star jacks. I want you to start down low, like you're in a cha-cha squat, or saying a prayer, or what's this in yoga? I forgot what that's called. Chair pose. Okay, so you're gonna start here, and then you're gonna explode and try to touch your hands at the top as your feet come out, looking like a star, okay? Then, we're gonna go right lateral lunge. Work the right side, explode up. Then, left lateral lunge, work the left side. And then we're gonna hit some pike taps down on the ground, repeat all that, and finish with 1 minute of core. All right, round four. Let's go. So get into that nice feet together. Drop it down, now explode. Up at the top. You're just gonna splay your legs out as your arms go to touch, land softly. Beautiful. Land soft, that's really important. Softly, if you need a modification, give me some jumpy jacks. That's your modification. I want to see you try this though. Right lateral lunge. Step out, drive it up. Chest up, head up. Booty back. I told you, we're hitting every area of the lower body today. Hey, come on. Stay with me. Oh yeah, we're turning up. We got left lateral lunge. Let's go. Way to stay with it. Way to challenge yourself despite being tired. It's okay if you hate me. You'll love me later. When you feel good, when you accomplished a challenging workout, when you look good, when you got that sweaty glow. And pike taps down into that high plank position. I want you to hike your hips up. Press your head in between your biceps and then reach back, touch. Return to high plank. Do the other side, opposite hand, opposite foot. Good, let's go. Perfect. Two, and back to our star jacks. Let's go. Star jack time. Remember, if you are modifying, that's okay. Jumping jacks, but no lazy jacks. We're not doing any of this. I want to see good jumping jacks. Let's go. Stay with me. You are almost done. Two, and right lateral lunge. Woo! I know. Yes. One round at a time. This is the end of round four. Beautiful. Conditioning is not for the weak of heart, but I tell you what, it makes a difference in your bag workouts. Left lateral lunge. Ha. Stay with me. DJ, you can change this one, please. Woo! Didn't make it hard, or make it easy, I mean, for J-Ball today. It's over on the ring. Let's get it. We got pike taps next. Ha! You can't have slow music when you're doing conditioning. Let's go. You can skip this one as well. Pike it up, reach back, touch. Woo! Come on. Music matters when you are in here sweating and working hard. Ooh! Come on. We're gonna finish off with some bicycles. I'm curious. Turn it around on your booty. What music do you listen to when you're doing intense workouts? Bicycle. So, no tricycles here. We're not doing little baby ones, okay? We're doing full extension. Opposite elbow, opposite knee. Rotate. My head is elevated. My shoulders are elevated. Keep going with me. Beautiful. Come on. 20 seconds. Perfect. Stay with me. 10 seconds all the way through the bell. Do not quit. I'm going and I'm talking. Let's go. Rest. Let me tell you what. If you can do a minute of bicycles, you're a gangster, okay? Because that is not for the faint of heart. A minute of bicycles is hard work. Good work. All right, here we go. Final round. You made it. Round 5, conditioning. Feeling good. We're going to move into high knee skaters, but we're going to move them laterally. So you're going to high knee laterally drop and then skate. And we're going to do that again. We're going to work that both sides. Then we're going to sit down on our left leg and we're going to cha-cha squat. All my weight, we're going to step out at an angle and then back. Then we'll switch to the left side. Hit some push-ups and then cycle through that one more time and finish off with some core for the final 1 minute of this 5-round conditioning. Probably one of the hardest modalities on the app. All right? Come off to the side. Start with your inside leg. We're gonna high knee it out, land on the outside foot, and then you're going to skate. High knee, skate. Stay going this side because we'll reverse and do the other side next time. Reach back. Get your hands up. Let that leg come back behind you. And cha-cha squat. All the weight on your right side. Right leg. I'm gonna step out at an angle and back. I'm just touching, tapping the ground. All my weight is on my balancing leg. Focusing on it. Come on. Come on. We're gonna switch sides. Ooh, I feel it. I feel the blood rush. 5 seconds. 3, 2, switch. Woo! Perfect timing. 3 points. Out, angle, back. Feels like a dance. This is why it's called cha-cha. Come on. Hey! Slow and be proud. Push-ups, let's get it. Walk your feet out. Now from this position, your elbows are gonna go back at an angle, and then you drive up. If you need to drop to your knees, straight spine, and I want you to drop your chin to the ground. Exhale on the way back up. Stay with me, we got 10 seconds. Feet, shoulder width apart. And pop it back up. Now we're gonna start on the opposite end for high knees, starting with the inside leg. Stop on the opposite, or the outside leg. Skate. How did that work out? No, that's right. High knee, outside leg, skate. Almost done. And right cha-cha squat. Here we go. Woo! My legs, man. All the weight on the right. Out. Angled. Back. Come on. This is it. Halfway done with this round. Come on. All the weight. You can even touch this quad to make sure you're feeling the blood rush. Remember, if it was easy, everyone would be doing this. Other side, left side, come on. Push yourself. Drive. Killing it. We got one more set of push-ups, and we're finishing with windshield wipers for 1 minute. It's gonna be challenging, but hey, you made it all this way, 33-ish minutes, and you're gonna finish strong. Drop it, push-ups. Let's go. Whether you're on your knees or on your toes, let's go. I feel that I'm fatigued, so I don't wanna compromise my technique. No ego here, I'm dropping to my knees. Straight spine. If you wanna make it a little bit more challenging, lift your feet off the ground. I'd rather have good technique than try to show off. I don't wanna hurt myself. And windshield wipers. On your bottom, arms straight out to the side. Legs straight up, here we go. You're gonna use your arms for support and you're gonna drop your legs over as far as you can go. Pull, pull, pull them around. Other side. Literally, like windshield wipers. Try to keep them straight. Lots of oblique here. 30 seconds, let's go. You're crushing this. 20 more seconds, dig. Pull your core. Pull it around. Ten seconds. Finish strong. All the way through the bell. Three, two. Beautiful. Woo! While we're down here, let's stretch it out. Awesome work today. And we're actually gonna start in our dead bug position. So on your butt and back, please. And we'll get this popping in 3, 2, and 1. Legs up and tabletop, arms straight to the sky. We're gonna drop a left leg and right arm just over the ground and then bring it back up. I want your knees together when they come into this upright position. Now really try to focus on keeping your lower back glued to your mat. Beautiful. So we really make sure we're engaging and switching on our lower abs. Good. Now right after this, in about 25 seconds, we're gonna go straight into some bicycles. We're gonna do a bicycle push for 45 seconds. Good work. Keep going. Couple more reps. Point your toes. Straight, straight fingers. Energy shooting out of them. Last one right here. 2 and 1. Hands just behind your ears, supporting but not pulling. And I'm gonna take my leg straight out. I'm gonna bend one knee. I'm gonna try to touch it with my opposite elbow. See how my legs are fully extended? We're gonna go ahead and switch. Other side. Now we're not doing tricycles here. I want full big boy bikes. Extend and rotate. Point your toes. You're gonna get a rest after this, so push. Our hands are not pulling on our neck. We're just gently supporting behind our ears as we rotate our head and our upper body. It's almost rest time. In 3, 2, and 1. Take a 15-second rest. Now, what we're gonna do is a progression. We're gonna do our dead bugs, but we're gonna do them as holds. So we're gonna do a 30-second dead bug hold with one side, and then we're gonna transition and do a dead bug hold on the other side. Up into our tabletop position, arms straight up. Now, glue your lower back to the mat now. Now I'm gonna drop my right arm and my left leg. Now be mindful that our knee is not coming forward. Try to keep it at that angle. Come on, punch your toes. We're just off the ground, we're not dropping. This is intermediate, come on. And we're going to transition in 3, 2, 1. Back to the top. Catch your breath. Other side. Lower it down. This is good. I feel it in my hip flexors. I know my lower abs are being switched on. I know we're using stabilizing muscles. Keep your lower back glued to the mat. Come on. Crushing it. We're going to go straight into bicycles again for a 45-second push. I feel like Peloton up here. Pushing on the bike for 45 in 3, 2, and 1. Hands just behind your ears, gently supporting. Let's get it. Come on. Earn your rest. Oof. Feeling it. Then our final exercise is just going to be a 60-second plank. You got this. But we will have a 15-second rest in between. Come on. Ah. Less than 15. I'm on Struggle Street with you. I'm feeling this. 5 more seconds. 3, 2, and rest. Woo, baby. Over onto our front. We got 15 seconds to get there. I want us to start in our forearm plank, please. Forearms down, and then you're gonna walk your feet out in 3, 2, and 1. Now walk your feet out. I want your elbows directly underneath your shoulders. Plant all your fingers into the ground. Your back is straight as a board. Now we're gonna go ahead and turn it up for the final seconds. Now if you do need to modify, you're gonna drop to your knees, but you're still gonna be in this straight spine position. All right, we're not sinking, we're not sticking our butt up in the air like we're about to get some feed like we're a chicken. So straighten this. Now I want you to start to elevate up into a high plank and then lower back down into a low. Now I want you to switch which hand you elevate up in, bring it back down. Let's keep this going. This is called a plank up down. Switching the side that you press up into. Come on. Almost done. And time. Immediately drop your core to the ground. Woo! Stretch it out in Cobra. Yo, I felt that too. I'm glad we did that together. Go ahead and press back into your heels. Spread your knees a little bit wider. Press your palms into the ground. Intermediate core. I see you guys in the Fight Camp community, though. You guys crush the core workouts, and I always see you stack, and that's what we want. But you guys turn it up when it comes to core work, and you're going to be so grateful for that. Because then you're going to prevent yourself from maybe getting lower back pain or bad posture. So important to work on your core, especially stabilizing.